Hello YouTube and welcome to Torchlight 2. Just going to be making a real quick introductory video showing you how to create a character and going through the first area through the first safe zone. Just a quick intro, Torchlight 2 is the sequel to the original Torchlight. It's been in development for a couple of years and I've been looking forward to it for a while. I was a bit of a fan of the original Torchlight and looking at the features and content that they were adding to the game. Been looking forward to it for a little while, and I'm happy to say that it is it's meeting those expectations as well. It's been a lot of fun the last couple of days playing it. So I wanted to make a quick intro just to show you how this first bit works. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail into these character classes. We'll make some videos later on going into more depth, looking at the skills and stats for the characters, for the classes. Let's have a quick look at what we've got. We've got an Ember Mage, and this is a cool feature. You can choose between male or female for each class. We've got a Berserker, the male and the female. Engineer, that's the Outlander, female and the male. Ranged class, and an Engineer, which will be the big wrench, male and the female. We've got probably the Ember Mage and the Outlander look to be your ranged classes, and your Engineer, your Berserker are probably more of your melee class characters. As I said, I'll go into more detail into that later on. We're going to create a Berserker. I've been playing through single player as an Engineer. I've been playing in co-op with a friend as I've been playing as an Ember Mage in co-op. And my friend's been playing as a Berserker. It looks like a lot of fun, the Berserker class, so I wanted to do that for this video. You'll also see here we've got some customizations for each class, so you can choose where it says face, even though it's changing the skin color as well. You can choose different hairstyles and also hair color. So let's go with that, and then choosing character name. Let's go with Brenner the Berserker. Once we select that, now we've also got some more options here for pets. Original Torchlight just had cat and the dog, a wolf. But now we've also got a panther, and we can customize the appearance of the pets as well. The bulldog, we've got a chocowary or chakowary, however you'd like to pronounce that. Sure what that is. We've got a ferret, a papillon, cute little puppy dog, a hawk, and I've been using the hawk as my engineer. I like the hawk just because it's different to all the others. All the others are four-legged creatures. The hawk's a bird, so obviously it's different. I'm going to use a bulldog. Brown and white bulldog for mine, and this is cool, you can randomize the pet names here. If you're like me and are horrible at making up names for characters or pets, you can just randomize it until you find one you like and hit OK. Okay, so we've got your difficulty level now, fairly standard, casual through to elite, and you've also got a hardcore mode. So if you choose hardcore mode and you die, death is permanent, so you'll lose that character. I'm just going to choose normal, just because I want more action in this video rather than me dying and respawning. This is one of the new features. We've got internet, so you've got co-op for Torchlight 2. You can play over the internet with friends, or you can play over LAN. So if you've got other people in your house that own the game as well, you can play over your LAN, or even if you have a LAN party. I'm just going to do single player. I will do another video on setting up a multiplayer game. We'll stick with single player for this one. I am going to skip through the intro video, and I'm going to skip past a lot of the speech dialogues.
I think this is as far as I can go.
If you want to have a look at the videos and more detail into the speeches and stuff, I'd recommend going and buying the game. It's out on Steam. It's been released on September the 20th. I believe it's $20 at the moment on Steam. I'll verify that. And I'll probably put a link in the description below to the Steam page for it. I'm probably a little bit biased in that I'm quite a big fan of the original Torchlight, and I do like action RPGs, so that's kind of the reason for making this video, is just to show, if you don't know what the game is, to show you what it is, you know, how to get started. And if you like what you see, yeah, I'd support the developers, go out and buy the game. You won't regret it. From what I've heard, they've added approximately 4 times the amount of content over the original Torchlight. I watched a video earlier in the week that had one of the developers there talking about it, and he was saying that the original Torchlight took around about 8 hours to complete. Torchlight 2 has 4 acts, and even though Act 4 is not as long as Acts 1 to 3, he did say that it takes roughly about 8 hours to complete each act. So you're looking at about 30 to 40 hours worth of gameplay. For $20, that's pretty good. I reckon that's pretty good value. And that 30 to 40 hours of play is for a single playthrough. So when you complete the game, he was saying that you should be at about level 50. The level cap is 100, and you've got the option when you complete the game through the first time that you can stay at the end game and you can purchase these dungeon scrolls, which will take you through to a unique dungeon with a unique challenge, and when you complete that challenge you'll get some unique loot that drops. So you can continuously go and purchase those maps and grind out new gear. Or you've got the option of going through to a game plus mode. If you look at... talk about that in a sec. If you notice there, my hands were glowing and I was running a lot quicker than I do normally. My charge bar was filled. So we'll talk about that when I get through to the safe zone. What that was and how that works. Your game plus mode. So when you finish the first playthrough, you can go to this game plus mode, which takes you right back to the very start of the game, but you start at your current level. So if you're at level 50 and you finish, you'll start the game again at level 50, and all the enemies will be harder. You'll get through my charge bar full again. Let's just see. Can we do it? No. Oh, maybe. Yes, here we go. So, if you see, all the hits that I'm doing are doing critical hit damages. Sorry, critical hits. For normal attacks. That's what happens with the charge meter for the Berserker. We'll have a quick look at that right now, just because that happened. So you see down here, this charge bar, that increases for enemies that you hit. It will deplete if you don't attack enemies for a while, so you can see that depleting now. When it gets full, I will go into a frenzy state for 6 seconds, and every normal attack that lands will be a critical hit. So that's pretty cool. When you get a big mob of enemies to fight, you get your frenzy meter up full, and that means you'll be dealing critical hit damages to all the enemies in 6 seconds. And you can increase that. We'll have a look at what happens with leveling up. You can increase the duration of those. I'm just going to backtrack just for a brief second. Before I do, I'll turn this quest in. NPCs that have a filled in question mark means that you've got a quest to turn in with them. Now, I just fought off some beasties with this guy, and he's happy about that, so he's going to reward me with some gear. So you get a choice here. I can either choose a weapon for myself, or I've got here a item for my pet. So I'm going to choose the pet item. We'll see why when I get through to the safe zone. I just wanted to backtrack here because I may have missed something. And I'm going to speed this bit up just because I want to keep this video nice and short. So we'll see you in a moment. Okay, so we're back. I didn't miss it. It's just up here. I'll probably cut that piece of video out anyway. So this is a new item, a new chest for Torchlight 2. It's a locked golden chest. So if you do come across one of these in the game, it's worth your while to try and find the enemy that drops the golden key. I've found the golden key already, and you see the amount of loot that drops out of that compared to a normal chest. It's definitely worth your while trying to find the golden key to unlock those chests. So that's pretty cool. It's something a little bit different to the original, and yeah, something different. I don't think I've seen it in other games. Yeah, there has been locked chests before, but that one's quite unique in that they do hold a lot more items than a normal chest, and you need to find something to unlock it, which is pretty cool. There's a chance that, so this is a normal chest. You'll see only a few items dropped out of that, a little bit of gold. So we've made it to the Enclave. This is our safe zone for Act 1. Now this will be the hub that you return to. And you'll see here on the mini-map, we've got a flashing question mark, that's this fella here. I need to turn in my quest with this guy. And again, I've been given a reward for finishing this quest. So let's choose Fist Weapon. He's giving me another quest straight away again. There is an NPC down here with the exclamation mark. That means he wants to give me a quest. So I'm going to speak to him and pick up that quest as well. I want to show you these two chests here in your safe zones, or in the hubs, the world hubs. You'll have a shared stash and a normal stash. The normal stash is just linked to this character. I can put items in here, and only this character can access those items. The shared stash, it's shared between all of your characters. So I've been and I've put a few items in here that I wanted to show. A little thing from leveling up, and you can see I've got quite a few items in here from the previous playthrough. So there are your two chests. Just looking at leveling up now, I'm bringing up my skill pane and my character pane. Every time you level up, you get 5 stat points and 1 skill point to assign, and it's just a matter of hitting the plus buttons there to add your stats where you want. You were given a skill by default when you start, and again, I'm going to go into more detail into all of these things for each character. But I'm just going to choose a couple that I already know that I want to do, and probably in the next video that I'm going to go keep this character through as a let's play video, I will explain what those skills are that I've chosen. Let's look at equipping some items. I've already got some equipped, so you can see as I've picked items up, they've been auto-equipped to slots. So things that, if I don't have anything equipped, if I can equip them when I pick them up, it'll automatically put them in, which is pretty cool. So let's have a quick look. I've got some rewards here I got from the quest, so to equip them, it's just a matter of left-clicking to pick it up, left-clicking to drop it. You can also right-click to equip the item. It's a nice quick way of doing it. You do also have a secondary slot, so you might want to put a ranged weapon as your secondary slot. Now I've got an unidentified weapon here that I've found, and to identify it, all you have to do now in Torchlight 2, it says there, right click to identify the item. So that's all you need to do to identify. As long as you've got identify scrolls, you can identify items. So that's a pretty cool weapon. I'll probably save that for later on. And you'll see here I can't use it. It's got a red X. There's a few items in my inventory at the moment that have got red X's. I can't use them. Now if I look at these three here, let's get this one here, and that's actually a duplicate. They all require 11 focus for me to use. The cannon only requires 10, but these other two need 11 focus. So as you saw when I leveled up, I've left 4 stat points here. Now I like to do that just in case I find some items that I need to put a few extra points into one of the stats before I can equip it. So if I do that now, you can see the X has disappeared from those 3 items, or 4. So I can now equip those gloves, I can equip the helm, and in my secondary slot I can equip the cannon, which is kind of cool. It's massive. It's the weapon that I tend to use more with my engineer. Yeah, that's leveling up and equipping items. I am going to leave it at that for the moment, guys. I hope you enjoyed this intro. Stay tuned for more. I'm going to continue this character on as a let's play. I'm going to go into a little bit more detail into the skills in those videos. Please leave me any comments below if there's anything you'd like to see. And yeah, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more.